how to quit. Ako yung nagsispeaker ako before, kaya ito sinasabi ko mga nasa sales, you have to learn how to eat rejection for breakfast. You have to learn how to eat rejection for breakfast. Once a seminar I did for a real estate company, mga 900 people nandun. Naisip ko lang siya, parang sasalta ako, on fire na eh. Sabi ko, you need to learn how to eat rejection for breakfast. Biglang naisip ko, teka, sandali lang, alam niyo pa yung kumpanya niyo? Apat na beses yun ako ni-reject na speaker. Sabi ko nung gano'n, and now I'm here, tawa ng tawa yung SVP dun sa unan. Sabi niya, Jayson, I'm sorry, I didn't know. Sabi ko, ma'am, it's okay, I'm just joking. But thank you for having me. And that same company sent me to Australia, sent me to Kuwait. Why? Because if you're in sales, if you get rejected, okay, pag ni-reject tayo, alam niyo ba, it's not your loss. It's whose loss? Parang ano ah, parang hindi kayo makasagot. Diba? Pag nire-reject tayo, okay lang yun. The more you are rejected, the more you will be accepted. Okay? But don't tell that to your client. Ha? Baka naman, ay, nireject ka. Ay, it's your loss. Diba? Huwag naman ganon. Pag nakatalikod na, no? Tsaka ka na umiyak. No? Diba, Lord? Pero, ibig sabihin yan, yung confidence natin, alam natin, we will give them the best that we can do, that we can afford, that we can give. Alam nyo ba, gusto nyo malaman ang difference ng loyal clients and regular clients? Would you like to know? Ayaw niya, sige, again, thank you very much. Gusto nyo malaman?
Yes.
Okay, makinig kayo mabuti, napaka-importante nito. Ito ang difference. Ang clients, they will get from you. Ang regular clients, they will refer you to others. Ang loyal clients, they are willing to get inconvenienced to work with you. I love Toyota. I have a relative who has a Toyota distributorship. Pero alam niyo yung kasabihan, it takes 10 hours to build a Toyota, but it takes 6 months to build a Rolls-Royce. Pag Rolls-Royce, kailangan niyong pumila. At hindi pa pwedeng bumili pag hindi tayo qualified, kahit may pera ka. They are willing to be inconvenienced. I'm so happy because I've developed some relationships with clients to the point that they will text me, Jayson, are you available on this date? We will have an event. Kung hindi, ano yung available dates mo? So ako nagbibigay ng available dates. Why? Because I've developed that relationship with them that they are willing to be inconvenienced. Dahil alam nila that I will give them not just 100%, but 1,000%. Do you follow? Pakitindin niyo katabi? Sabi mo, give. Isa pa, give. 1,000%.
1,000%.
Okay, sagutin mo ulit. Sabi mo, sige nga.
Sige nga.
Pautang ulit. Okay, this is my daughter. Her name is Gabby. And this was when she was 4 years old. And Gabby, one time she was watching Disney. Nakita niya yung Disneyland, Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, the princesses. Liit-liit na itsura niya, lapit sa akin. Sabi niya, Daddy, can we go to Disneyland? I like to go to Disneyland. Sabi ko, anak, you need to pray to God first before we can go to Disneyland. Yung kasi yung time na bankrupt kami. Ginawa ni Gabby, no, on the spot, pumikit, tumakas sa kamay, todo emot yung mukha. Lord God, please, I want to go to Disneyland. Now. Amen. Daddy, can we go na to Disneyland? So, in-explain ko pa, anak, we need to ride an airplane, we need to save money. Hindi ako tinantanan. Alam niya yung why niya eh. Every day, Disneyland. Nalaman na ng buong pamilya namin, nalaman lahat ng mga kaibigan namin. One time, nasa Green Hills kami, nag-church kami. Tapos meron doon isang kiosk ng Swatch doon sa V-Mall. Eh, nakita nung anak ko yung Swatch na Hello Kitty. Nagmana siguro sa akin, may isa lalo. Nakita nung ninang, magki-Christmas. Sabi nung ninang, Miss, pwede mong pahiram yung relo? Suot natin sa bata, baka gusto. Disunod kayo kay Gabby. Tinanong niya, Gabby, I'll let you choose, okay? What do you like? Do you want me to give you some money for Disneyland or do you want me to buy that watch for you? Eh, yung anak ko, alam niya yung why niya eh. Sagot kagad, Disneyland. I'll ask you again, Gabby, watch or Disneyland? Disneyland. Last time, Gabby, watch or Disneyland? Disneyland. Tapos alam niya yung mga bata pag nahihiya, nagsasalta niyong maintindihan kasi umubulong. Sabi ni Gabby, Ninang, What, Gabby? Louder. What? Louder. Ninang, can I bring the watch to Disneyland? Sabi nung gano'n, no? Pag alam mong why mo, kahit bata ka, gagawa ka talaga ng paraan. So kahit na bankrupt kami noon, ayan ang nangyari. My kids, we were able to go to Disneyland. They say that Disneyland is the happiest place on earth. I beg to disagree. It's one of the loneliest places on earth, especially for my pockets. Okay? Tapos nag-Disney Hotel kami. And, yan, nasyak ako paglabas ng bill. Mas mahal pa yung ticket namin, no? Mas mahal pa yung pa-parlor nila sa ticket namin apat, papunta at pabalik. Eh, sa galing ng anak ko, nakahanap pa rin ng sponsor, pati dun sa, ano, sa pa-parlor. Start with why. Yan ang importante sa lahat. three types of people who goes to work. The first are those people who treats their work as a job. The second are those who treats their work as a career. The third are those people who treats their work as a calling. Yung job, nandito tayo 15:30, we're here for the money, that's good because we need to earn a living. But if that's the reason why we're doing it, then we will not have any up, we will not have any power. Yung second naman career, usong-uso yan sa mga millennials. Yung mga tao who uses their work as a launching pad to other careers. Again, that's okay, pero kung yun lang mahirap, yung mga tao na umaasenso, who moves to the next level, are those people who treats their work as a calling. And here's the good news. Kahit na ano yung background natin, kahit na janitor po tayo, we can turn our work into a calling. May mga kilala ko ngayon, yung work nila simple lang, pero love nila yung trabaho nila. Meron din ako mga kakilala na mayayaman. Some of them are even my relatives na sayang, or even friends. Pero pag nakita mo, hindi na silang masaya sa ginagawa nila. Bakit? Kasi yung kanilang negosyo, hindi na siya calling, naging job na lang for them to earn money. So the question again is, how can we turn this work that we're doing into a spiritual pursuit? Because you are making a difference in the lives of people. You are offering them something that will last a lifetime and that they can pass on to the next generation. I want you to watch this video. And this video will show you the power of turning your work into a calling. Watch this video.